All right, welcome back to Resident Evil 7. This is my fourth time trying to record the last hour, half hour, depending on how fast I move. So I'm hoping it works. Like, for real. Okay, so what we've learned is Lucas has been communicating with someone sending encrypted messages. We'll find out a little bit more about that in a moment. But it looks like my original theory on Lucas might be correct after all. You don't have to take out the molded bit. I got enough ammo to do so, so why not? It's an herb. I want to see if there's a Mr. Everywhere here. I think there is. I don't know the exact location, though. So let's just continue. We're going down into the salt mine. Go through. Thank you. Let's take care of these mines or bombs. Seeing those reminds me of this video of someone's playthrough of The Last of Us, where Joel warns Ellie about the wire and tells her to keep her head down. But she accidentally runs into it and blows herself up. Gaming glitches, they can be great. Nice and dead. You too. Make sure I get that one, because I often forget it's there. And I know there's a Mr. Everywhere here. Might as well get Even though I won't be getting them all this playthrough, might as well get the last few. So when I do play the another playthrough, I don't have to worry about them so much for the trophy. Just feel safer closing that door. Alright. Sent Friday, January 16th, 2015. Thanks to you guys, it's been about a week since my head's been clear and back to normal. And she still thinks she's got me. You guys really need to work on fixing that. Not only does she look like a little kid, but she's about as stupid as one, too. Mom and Dad are still totally under, though. I was wondering, is this whole family obsession something you guys programmed into her? It's kind of fucked up. Sent Friday, November 4th, 2015. That bitch Mia is still somewhere in between Evie La La Land and reality. She gets pretty violent, so I locked her up in a cell. I thought maybe Eveline would get mad since Mia's her favorite and all, but she doesn't seem to care. She actually goes and visits her sometimes. She thinks Mia's her mommy. Like I said, your bioweapon is fucked up. Sent Friday, September 1st, 2016, about a year later. Eveline's family obsession is getting out of hand. She's making everyone kidnap more and more assholes off the street to add to her freak show of a family. Maybe she's getting tired of Mia not coming around, but it's a pain in the ass for me because I gotta clean up the mess whenever someone new comes along. By the way, Evie's looking sick or something. Her skin is getting all wrinkly and she's getting gray hairs. Isn't that supposed to happen? Is that supposed to happen? It's almost like she's getting old all of a sudden. She's not getting her proper treatments. This report details the symptoms that appear when the bacterium that grows inside of the E-Series infects a human. Be sure to read this document thoroughly before dealing with E-Series weaponized assets, hereafter referred to as mold. Initial infection. The mold ingests nutrients from the subject's body to propagate itself and slowly takes over cells within the body. As a side effect of this, the infected subject gains remarkable regenerative abilities. During experiments, we removed arms and legs from test subjects and found that they were able to co-opt the amputated limbs in a matter of minutes. Mid-stage infection. Once the mold reaches the brain, the subject's thoughts become in tune with those of the E-Series asset. The subject starts to hear things and experience hallucinations and soon comes under complete control of the E-Series asset. If this state continues, the host will lose all sense of ego. Complete infection. After every cell in the body has been taken over by the mold, the subject begins to lose their human form. Physical mutations differ from case to case, but all result in him or her acquiring incredible physical strength. Containing a subject at this stage would be extremely difficult. This is what happened to Jack and Marguerite. And as we can see, Ethan is in mid-stage infection. He has had hallucinations, both visual and audio, of Eveline. But he's not as far gone as Jack and Marguerite were. E-necrotoxin, E-series dosage test. 5 minutes after dose, vomiting. 10 minutes after dose, death. 12 minutes after dose, cell calcification. So that's what happened to Jack and Marguerite when we killed them for good. E-necrotoxin. Destroy cells of any subject based on the E-Series bioweapon model. Use only for disposal of E-Series assets. The toxin must first be stimulated before use. Do this by placing a sample of an E-Series cell into the necrotoxin container. Alright, and we got that. Let's get the necrotoxin. This project was instigated in 2000 as one of several concepts for the company's NexBus, Next Generation Experimental Battlefield Superiority Initiative. Working with technical assistance from HCF to develop a bioweapon for neutralizing combatants en masse with minimal direct contact. NexBus was later folded, and all its assets diverted to this project. What makes this project markedly different from conventional weapons is its ability to turn enemy combatants into allies, converting hostile elements into willing servants. Since this effectively eliminates the costs of not only POW handling, but also combat itself, It's no wonder we had the Redacted and even Redacted's Redacted organization chomping at the bit to get on board. The project would never have existed were it not for the discovery in Redacted of Redacted, the remarkably progressed vicariant evolution fungus that we commonly term the mutamycete. The fabrication method for each bioweapon was to introduce the mutamycete genome to a pre-stage 4 human embryo and perform cultivation in a controlled environment over a period of 38 to 40 weeks. The resultant organisms were referred to as candidate specimens and graded based on usability, from the impractical and faulty series A through D to the perfected E series. A common appearance was selected for the bioweapons, that of a roughly 10-year-old girl, to ensure ease of blending in with urban refugee population. So it seems that they aged Eveline up to look like a 10-year-old girl, when really she might be, you know, at the time of when Mia was with her on the boat, she could have been just a few months old. The first E-series specimens named Eveline has proven capable of secreting the mutamycete redacted from her tissue at will. It is also of note that Eveline's mutamycete imposes a profound control over body and mind when introduced into a host organism. We still have a lot to learn about the mechanism by which Eveline achieves and maintains this control, but the working theory is that the vector is similar to the autoinducer pheromones used for quorum sensing in Pseudomonas bacteria. Eveline's control is exerted in a series of discrete stages, the first of which is hallucination. Almost immediately after infection, the subject begins to see images of Eveline, though she is not in fact there, and even hear her voice, which is inaudible to anyone else. Auditions with infected subjects throughout the stages of infection reveal that at first, the phantom Eveline appears to be a normal young girl, sometimes desiring companionship or assistance. As time progresses, she begins making more and more extreme demands, including self-mutilation and attacks on other people. The psychological shock this induces helps to break down the mind's natural barriers to Eveline's brainwashing effect, and by the time mental control is achieved, the mutamycete infection has progressed throughout the body's cells, so the body redacted. Eveline's functions also include the ability to form organisms from mycelia, the fungal filaments. The term organism is used loosely here. Strictly speaking, they are superorganisms formed of countless mycelia. What's important, though, is that they exhibit a strong survival instinct and will defend themselves ferociously with the slightest provocation. Their fungal toughness and remarkable strength give them significant battlefield potential. The researchers have been calling these superorganisms the molded, made of mold, and also molded as in shaped. The name has a certain elegance to it. For the treatment of accidental infections, performing redacted on samples of Eveline's body tissue produces a unique fungicidal serum. Administering the serum to an infected subject will cause the mycelia to calcify, but if the subject's cells are already largely invaded, the serum will be fatal. Since the treatment window is so small, the serum's primary use is therefore disposal of infected subjects, rather than a cure. In exploring the serum's potential, we found that subjecting it to redacted would enhance its effects to extreme potency, becoming a compound we now called E-necrotoxin, which redacted in even tiny amounts. What's been interesting to observe in Eveline's behavior is her obsession with the concept of family. In experiments, we found on multiple occasions that infected subjects were compelled to act as her mother or father, treating her as if she were really their daughter. Why does she settle upon family as the theme for her mental control? This is just speculation, but it could be that she instinctively understands that a family unit is better suited to blending into social groups than a lone girl. On the other hand, well, a sentimental sort might suggest that she's making up for perceived lack of love in her quarantined upbringing, a parent's love. So basically, there's, depending on how sympathetic you are, a couple of reasons.
Thank you.
She's singing. I guess if you just want to avoid the molded, you can run through there. For me. Damn it. Don't really have a shotgun though. Yes, we're back here. So, I don't see the other doll, though. And this wasn't there the first time, but he's there now, Mr. Everywhere.
I'm sure of it. It's not here.
E001. There she is, the old woman.
Seeing this.
Ethan, it's okay. It's okay, it's me. I know you didn't mean to hurt me.
Kill him, Mommy.
But you shouldn't have done that! It fucking hurts!
He doesn't want to be my daddy? Then he can die. Now it's Mommy's turn to kill you.
You're gonna be one of us. And then maybe you'll play nicely.
I'm not playing.
No! Get that away from me!
Something terrible. You're just a little boy.
I'm Redfield. I'm glad we found you.
The fuck took you guys so long?
Ethan?
Mia. You made it. I'm glad.
Did I?
They say that when one door closes, another opens. Well, a door closed tonight. And what a long night it was. But not just for me. Me and I weren't the only victims here. So were the Bakers. It was that thing, Eveline, who made them that way. But now Eveline's dead. And these guys are here to clean up the mess. I had just come to terms with losing Mia. But now she's back and wants to start over. Put all this behind us. Maybe this is where the next door opens.
Raised in a deep, dark hole. The prisoner with no parole. They locked me up and took my soul. She's done. He'll be taught.